Okay, it's November 3rd, 2015, 4:14 p.m. It's Tuesday. My wife and I were out here tilling the garden. Oh man, we got ladybugs. We're infested with ladybugs. You can't really see them so much out here now. Well, you can a little bit. They're all over the house. They're getting in the house, all over the damn house inside. They got on the front door, the back door. So Southwest is bullshit. They get in every direction there is. The front is east, and they were just completely, it looked like wallpaper of ladybugs. We used our Civil War era tiller. I did about I did a lot of the garden. My wife did some too. But all the I call them tree stumps. They were okra stems that were sticking up over there. We pulled that plastic back and we tilled from that row of leaves back there. All that right there. We went down at least 8 inches from that center hole there of the tine. Oh, and down some because that the tiller, when it was in, it was like this. You know, it was just digging. The front of that red plate there was almost touching the ground. And it took some time, but we got it tilled up. We got adding in sunflowers around the edges here, which are going to get tore up next spring. So everything is done out here until spring now. These were all tilled up about 2 or 3 weeks ago, 4 weeks ago. No, about 3 weeks ago. And then that one there, and then that side over there of the number 1, 2, and 3 garden on the east end, which would be on that side of the row of leaves there is east. That was done first. Then I did this one, or that one, then I did this one. And then we did this one here. And like I say, I was tilling down as best I can. There was 27 okra plants out here. And they're like little tree trunks. And we had to dig down and dig down and dig down to get them. My wife pulled up about 8 of them, 10 of them. And I just kept digging and digging. Then at the end, I just was down so deep with the tiller until I started hitting them. And I would just rip them up and everything. So, matter of fact, they're right there. I forgot about them. See, look at these. See, that thing is about 3 inches. That's about 4 inch diameter there. If you went from one end to the other, it's 3 inches. And there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25 right here. But there were 27 total, so I don't know. You know why? A couple of them were doubles, I think, like a V. But you can see where it ripped the plastic when we pulled it back off because they were coming up through the plastic, and when we folded the plastic that way, we had to pull it and we ripped the plastic. But I'm not gonna do it right now. My knees are hurting so bad. They're burning. I'm gonna unfold the cuts in the plastic. That's where they were growing up out of. And next year, this will be tomatoes over here. We'll have 5 deep and try to have at least 3 rows of tomatoes, 15 tomato plants. And they produce a lot when they have the space. And like I said, we learned a lot from this year. This year we had a lot, but the tomatoes were bad. We were up in this other one here. We had a lot of hornworms, lots of major problems with hornworms. And just other things. But like I say, now I've got this down. Year to year, we keep changing things. We got garlic we're going to put in that. There's a walkway over there before. But now we're going to have like 3 on an angle and probably about 10 rows of it, of garlic. Beans and all that will be about, I don't know if I can see on the bottom here, around where that one is right there, all the way there. Starting with that one there, going that way. Probably have like 3 different beans across going that way because they run from south to north. And then we'll go on the other side. We'll put purple hull peas over here. Black-eyed peas right around where that row of leaves. I mean, all those leaves are going to go off there. We're going to maybe cover that walkway that I just tilled up for the garlic. I was thinking about putting leaves on, but I might put those leaves on them. And plant some garlic here in the next week. This will be tilled up maybe tomorrow or the next day because I'm going to have peanuts down there, sunflowers all down through here, maybe a peanut plant right here. You know, a peanut means putting down 4 peanuts to plant. And then over there, it's all grown up a lot because I haven't touched that for about 2 months. I tilled it one time, then I left it all where all those green flowers are. That's going to be all sunflowers, peanut in the middle, and 2 sunflowers on the other side there where that package there coming this way, and that's CJ's grave. So this was all the sunflowers this year. Those torch sunflowers, which there are some over there by the chimney, they're still putting out. No hummingbirds, it's too cold for the hummingbirds. A few bees, I've seen a couple bees. But next year we're gonna have sunflowers all the way around this garden, all the way around here. And like I said, I have peanuts on the corner there, peanuts on the end here. And I might do right where that walkway is there on the other side. There I might have peanuts over there. You know, you can see barely right. There's the little track where I tilled up for sunflowers. And it goes all the way down the end, and it goes on the other side too. So we'll have three peanuts over there in the corner. Three peanuts right here. And then three peanuts, I might just do the peanuts on the end where that pack is there. And then maybe on the corner over there. I might as well walk and let you see it. Oh man. Yeah, well you can see it's growing up in here too. See how this is all more primarily soil. But see, this was all tilled up. You can see the row with the line here. That was all tilled up here, and I just put sunflower stakes on here and leaves at one time because I was thinking they were gonna be spraying the field right here, which is about 20 feet behind me, north here. We've got 150 around us and 150 acres across from us. Monsanto, okay? So that's the challenge that we're having all the time. So that's how the garden's gonna be next year. It should be pretty good. Hopefully three rows of five tomatoes right here. Tomatillos might have, after that, about four or five tomatillos coming back. And then we'll start with purple hull peas. Try to get some another bean, like a string bean, a green bean. And then black-eyed peas. And then I don't know what. We might do watermelon and cantaloupe back here too, because right now we're tentatively gonna put the watermelon. We're gonna put like two watermelon and two cantaloupe up here. We're gonna have zucchini. See, zucchini was all over here. We had purple hull peas, black-eyed peas, and zucchini. We planted way too much of everything because everything with this plastic came up and we were overwhelmed. We got stuff canned up the butt. So next year we're gonna have about maybe six, maybe eight zucchini, probably six. And then we'll have a cantaloupe or two cantaloupes maybe. And like I said, we might have watermelon or something back here with these. So, oh boy, I gotta go in the house to get off my feet. My lower back and my knees are what's hurting really bad right now. All right, there's your neighbors. They're so self-contained. Yeah, this is a Civil War era tiller. The reverse doesn't work. You have to hold it yourself. You have to pick it up and pull it back. That's why it hurts so much, pulling it back. But like I said, we went down about 8 inches from the center of that axle all the way down and then some, and we were digging down. And we did that entire from the row of leaves there all the way across. And I'll tell you, that was a lot of work. And then we got a bow rake. My wife and I were kind of, we can't make it level, but we made it pretty level so there's no big holes or no dips. So as you can see, it kind of looks fairly level. So, well, we got peppers that I tore up all the peppers. I thought I left a few of them out here. Didn't realize they would grow. We got a couple of those long hot peppers. I call them pizza peppers. Growing on this one here. See, like that one there, there's three of them on there. But that's the longest. And there's a couple of bell peppers out here. I mean, like I said, I was going to tear them all up, and I just hadn't got to these. But they're growing peppers now. I'm just leaving them alone. Because this was going to get all tore up, too. And I got those cinder blocks. I was going to raise it up one all the way around. And then we have to buy about 20 bags of potting soil put in here for next year's peppers. We're not going to have as many peppers. But we'll have, instead we had 20, 21 out here, I think. We just put out like 16, 18 pepper plants. Because I had some out in the garden this year, as you see on other videos. But my torch sunflowers, I'm going to put them back where you see where the cinder blocks are there. I'm going to have them all in there in front of that window. I'm getting hummingbirds and honeybees, hummingbirds, and butterflies, the big butterflies. Oh, look, there's a bee right there. Oh, there's a couple of them. I don't know if I can see them on here. see it. See how there's one up there? See, I want to have them right in front of this window here. And I just dropped the seeds. I didn't make any kind of pattern, so I dropped them. They didn't really come out. These did, right in front of the chimney. Put some over there. Put some between those two windows right there, too. And you see how low they are. We're planted about the same time. Actually, no, I take it back. These were planted about a week or two before. Then I decided, well, let me do that there. No, but they were too late. But that's about where I want to plant them next year. I'm going to have them in front of the chimney here. On the side. In front of the chimney. And on the side. And then right there in front of that window there. You know, move where these cinder blocks are sitting right here. And then, again, there and there. And like I said, these will be all around the garden, like a giant horseshoe on the east, north, and west side. So, it's a lot of work. But I'll tell you what, man. We got a freezer still pretty full of vegetables. We didn't get as many tomatoes because of the hornworm, I think, challenges we had. And we bought a couple, which I didn't want to do, but I bought three or four of them from Kmart. And they did okay. But I blame those for the hornworms. I don't know. I'm probably wrong. But anyway, we had hornworms. And that really... And then at the end, the tomatoes started to put out after I was sitting here constantly killing everything off of them, the hornworms and everything. We had a bunch of smaller tomatoes, and I just tore up the tomato plants. And I could have left them. See, it's November 3rd right now. And we had maybe one frost, a light frost. So the plants would have probably lasted. You know, usually you can go into the third week of October, which I was trying to wait, but I pulled everything up about the first weekend of October. So we have a long summer, and with the plastic, that gives you about 3 weeks. So till about next week or the week after, we could probably still be growing things. But again, I was in a hurry. Everything came out so overwhelmingly good this year. Next year should be a whole lot better. So all I can say, folks, is grow yourself something. You know, if you can get a little place by your house or something, get some of those big 5-gallon buckets, which we have, but we got pecans now, because now we got trees full of pecans falling down. Got already about 800 or 900 pecans. I counted actually 200 in one bucket, and I've got two others that are a little bit about the same, a little bit more than that. But that's a pecan tree. That big one's a pecan tree, and that one right in the back, you can't really see it. There's one back in the back, but it gives you the little round pecans, you know, which are okay, but these here got some giant pecans. That one there, I picked up a few, but there's a lot on the ground over there still. This one right here is an old tree. This tree's been here probably, I'm going to say 90 years old, roughly, and it's got a lot of pecans over there. Not as good as the year we moved in here. They were, I mean, we had five-gallon buckets, and then people were getting them all the time, filling up their buckets. And but that tree in the back there with that tire up against it, that's a pecan tree back there, but it's got the round pecan. So okay, folks, I know you've watched my videos, listen to me cussing everything else, but I'll tell you what, you gotta grow some food. The chemtrail spraying they've been doing to our atmosphere, Fukushima, which they didn't tell anybody about. People have no idea about Fukushima. If you get a chance, look up Fukushima, F-U-K-U-S-H-I-M-A, Fukushima, Japan. It's a nuclear plant that had a tidal wave and a tsunami, actually. And they had meltdowns. They had four meltdowns or three meltdowns. I mean, total meltdowns. But then they've lied and they've changed things around, said there was no problems. But radiation's gone around the globe four or five times since March 11th, 2011. The Pacific Ocean is dying. The fish, the plankton and all that is dying, and the fish that eat, they, you know, the chain, it's just all dying off. So you need to buy some seeds or something. Try to get some heirloom seeds if you can. Heirloom solutions is where I go through, and like I said, you get very good nutritious food, even though it rains down from the chemtrail shit stuff. See, I didn't swear. So we got plastic over there, and it's just, like I said, it is a lot of work sometimes, but then the benefits are a lot better than buying the crap at China Mart. You know, you shop at China Mart and you get what they got because it's cheap and I can get a lot of stuff because it's cheap. Yeah, just think about it. You are what you eat, you know, cheap. So you are cheap. Your health will be cheap. So good luck is all I can tell you. we got to see what's going to happen. If we're going to have a summer next year, you know, we have things are so up in the air right now. It's like 2 minutes to midnight right now, if you know what that is. So it's serious, but you don't hear anything about it on the mainstream media because everything's fine. There's no unemployment. It's at 5%. 92 million people. Should be like 28 to 32%. But it's at 5%. Yeah, whatever. Just keep believing your bullshit. Oh, see, I had to swear. Take your blue pill and go back to sleep. I take red pills all the time. I'm wide awake.